Well, it was August and I had a big life change ahead. I was going to be leaving home and everything I knew for a while. But before I took off, we clocked a few good summer days in our golden New England hills. Weekend, we went with our good friends on a little northern getaway, where I would try something I had never done before in my life. We had 2 days up in the part of Vermont we had never been before, and we were being toured around by Jared and Greer, who visit this area every year. And on the first day, we headed to the river.
This is sick.
And when Jared and I took a little side trough, we ended up finding a shortcut to a rope swing.
Oh, yeah.
And so we figured we'd give the girls a surprise when they came around the bend. And there were wildflowers on the banks and signs of things to come.
Why
And on the next day, it was time to do that thing I had never done before.
Tell you what, if Kyle keeps hammering these jumps, it's really going to be like the nickname of Hawk. He's hawking up. Yeah, baby!
I used to ride bikes and hit jumps behind my house when I was a kid, but I've never gone downhill mountain biking. I took the first few runs really easy to get a feel, but as the day went on, I started getting more comfortable. Jared, on the other hand, was making every double jump look easy.
Woo! Yeah, boy! Oh dear. Yeehaw, brother. Woo! Killing it, dude.
It was a lot of fun out there on the trails, and it reminded me how badly I want to get bikes back home for Allie and I to ride. Last day of our trip, we moseyed our way over the New Hampshire line to check out a few fun spots on the way home. It felt like vacations I used to take in the White Mountains when I was a kid. And we would always stop at places like this along the way.
Are you kidding?
And on our way home from the trip, we caught the full moon above the hay fields. And by now, there wasn't many days until I had to leave home for this new life chapter. But I still snuck a visit into the tractor store to peek at used machines, as it would be very helpful for a lot of work we have to do at the cabin and the new house. Plus, I've just wanted a tractor for as long as I can remember.
This one's a little bit bigger.
And that same afternoon, Jared and I helped our friend John with the hay. While the work can be tough and scratchy, it's very satisfying, and it makes you feel deeper connected to the hills and the way people used to live.
Hey, Bob.
We stacked about 800 bales and then smashed plates of beef stroganoff, courtesy of John's father. And in the final few days before departure, Allie and I looked through old film photos, and I slowly packed up everything I would need for my new job. Easy does
it. Oh man.
Old Blue was running, it seemed like the distributor was failing and it needed to be dealt with ASAP. And on one of the final nights home, I cut up some seats and the nieces and nephews came over to the new house for a little summer campfire. If fear blinds you, let soothing pleasure bring you back till now. left Allie with a fresh loaf of bread before departure and finished gathering all my things. I think I have everything. Oh, I'm sad to leave, but I'm excited.
Oh, geez.
It's so hot. Let me get one more smooch.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you too. Mas.
Then I met up with Mason, and we loaded everything we were going to need for the massive project ahead.
Let the days be past, days of trying. Give up the air of perfection. Trust the simple ways.
I was going to be living by the ocean for 2 months, helping Mason restore his family's cottage.
It's so cool.
So, I feel like this is probably, this is my favorite room growing up.
This is so
you also could take this room, which is a bigger bed, and probably equally as awesome.
One of the first things we did after arrival was hit the water, as Mason had become big into spearfishing while he lived down in the Caribbean earlier this year. I had never really worn flippers or a snorkel, so it was going to take me a while to get used to all this, but there was plenty of time for that. The cottage was built nearly 100 years ago by Mason's great-grandfather, and in those 100 years, the old chimney has settled and leaned and began to take the house with it. Our goal was to remove the chimney, replace all the footings, and make the structure square and level again. It was a big job and a lot of work, but Mason had been planning and studying for many months, and he had a good plan. I've learned a lot from Mason in the past, and I was ready to learn a lot more. And all the while, balance work and play, and savor some of this oceanside lifestyle that's so different from my life in the hills.
Oh,
first evening, I set up my bedroom in my office. I was planning to keep producing videos and work on them in the mornings and the evenings.
Cheryl lives down in the south, working at the Waffle House, has a second job at midnight when it's time to leave. Costs $7.50, never seems to pay the rent. You gotta have a trick or two that's hidden up your sleeve. But living ain't a magic act, days are long and that's a fact. Money still ain't quite enough for her and all the kids. Times have changed, she always says, the good old days are gone dead. She tucks the kids into their bed like mama always did. But it's hard when you ain't got nobody, and it's hard when nowhere feels like home. And it's hard when
I settled in fast that first night and went to bed excited for the next day, where we'd start phase one if the rain would let us.
He was laid off just last week, make parts for big machines that made a lot of fancy things, but folks don't buy no more. Now he's in an old motel.
You're trying to use as little energy as possible.
That he's never felt before.
It already feels like home up there.
Yeah. Some nights when it's getting late, a diner by the interstate serves him up a nice hot plate, a filling for time. Cheryl's always working there, big blue eyes and all the hair. She treats him nice and seems to care about what's on his mind. But it's hard when
and so we started setting up the staging and began taking measurements to find out how far out of square the structure was. After work, I got in a workout and was hoping to start keeping the fitness consistent.
Quarters.
And we stayed steady through that first week. And as we went on, I began to understand little ins and outs of the project much better. And when it downpoured hard, even more reasons for these renovations became clear. The weather would change fast by the ocean, and we adjusted our work accordingly. A lot of this first week was setting up the groundwork for what was to come, and we'd call it quits with enough time to enjoy the last of the sun. These first few days felt really good. I was happy I had taken this opportunity on and looking forward to seeing the plan unfold. I could have stayed home and kept chipping away at things back there, doing the same kind of stuff I've done the last three summers. But instead, I was in a new place with a new task, and everything felt right. This was an uncomfortable thing for me to take on in the beginning, but by pushing through that discomfort, I had opened up a whole new world. And that's what life is about, pushing through and discovering.